everyone. For today's video, I am going to be doing the $20 makeup challenge. For today's video though, I was able to keep the cost of the full face $20 and also make the full face only contain 5 products. The reason I was able to do that though is because this is also a full face of e.l.f. Cosmetics. I know back in the day when people used to do their $20 makeup challenges, e.l.f. used to be considered like cheating because all their products were already so dirt cheap. But I asked you guys on Instagram if you guys would be okay if the $20 makeup challenge was still all e.l.f. Cosmetics, and I think like 300 of you guys said yes and only 3 of you guys said no. So if you consider this to be cheating, I'm very sorry, but blame it on Instagram, not on me. I just think e.l.f. is such a good affordable brand. Not only is it affordable, but it also performs really nicely. The packaging is so cute and you can basically find it anywhere. You can get it at any drugstore, any Walmart, any Target, and Ulta. I'm going to start out by using the e.l.f. 16 Hour Camo Concealer. I use the shade Medium Beige in this concealer. I do find that it oxidizes to get pretty dark, so that is something to keep in mind when shopping for this concealer. And I do think on me personally, the Medium Beige shade is a little too dark for me, especially when it does oxidize. But it is okay, it's still very much workable. It doesn't look too dark right now, but I do notice it does get a little bit darker. And another thing about this concealer that you need to be careful of is you need to blend it out pretty much as soon as you apply it. So if you are covering, you know, the majority of your face with this concealer, I really would recommend working in sections, maybe just doing like your eyes first, and then your nose, and then your chin, and then your forehead, and blending as you go, because this concealer is pretty dang mattifying, which, you know, for oily skin is pretty nice and it will look really beautiful as the day goes on. But yeah, since it does dry matte, you do not want to wait to blend this concealer out or you will get stuck with spots on your face that will not blend out. And because I'm not using a foundation for this look today, I am covering up a little bit more than I usually do with my concealer just to make sure that my whole face sort of has some base going on. And I also especially like to use a sponge with this product, obviously to add a little bit of extra hydration and make sure that the concealer blends out to be really nice, smooth, and seamless. So that is what my base looks like with just the concealer. Because it is a matte concealer, I don't notice the concealer to be super duper tacky. And to cut down on the price of the full face and to keep it at only 5 products, I am not going to be setting my face with powder. So a newer product to e.l.f.'s line are these Bite Size Blush Duos. These are only $3, which is crazy affordable. It comes in a lot of different options, a lot of different color options, and these blush duos all come with a color side and a highlighter side. This very top one is coconut, and this seemed to be the only sort of bronzer option that they had. And the two blush options I have is Spiced Apple, which is this top one, and Leche, which is the bottom one. For today's look, I'm going to be using the e.l.f. Bite Size Blush Duo in Spiced Apple. The highlighter on this end is a little dark. It's pretty deep. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to take some on my brush and I'm going to apply it underneath of my blush shade so that it's not too noticeable that the highlight is a little bit more dark. And I'm also going to drag the highlight a little bit down so that I can make sure that the rest of the cheek is glowy because the blush side is more matte. Going to take some on the brow bone because that's always pretty. Also, I'm going to hit the nose, hit the cupid's bow, and the chin. I'm going to now dip in to the blush side. This is a really cute blush. It doesn't really remind me of apples though. More peachy, I feel. But, ooh, this is beautiful. I love this. Ooh, that is so cute. That is such a cute, cute blush shade. For my brows and eyeshadow, I am going to be using the Bite Size eyeshadow in Cream and Sugar. And this shade right here, this very dark shade, works perfectly in my eyebrows, which is really great. I really like this dark brown shade from the Cream and Sugar palette because it is a little bit more of a true brown. It doesn't really lean too warm or too cool, which is exactly the kind of shade that I prefer in my brows. And yeah, as you can see, it just works really, really well for my natural hair color. So brows are all filled in. I honestly think that this brow powder match in my brows looks so good. Very natural. I really like the look of brow powder in my brows. I feel like they end up looking really defined but still very soft, so I like that look. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to dip my brow brush that I was just using and I'm going to line my eyes with it across my lash line, just sort of repurposing the brow brush because obviously it's an angled brush, so you can use it as an eyeliner brush as well. I probably should have had you guys in closer for the brows anyway, but I pulled you guys in closer at least to see the eyes. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to take the deep, deep brown and mix it in with this lighter shade because I don't want my crease shade to be too dark. So by mixing those two eyeshadows, I'm able to create a lighter crease shade. Because I am a warm tone girl and I feel like the eyeshadows in the Cream and Sugar palette are a little bit more on the cool toned or neutral side of things, but this brown obviously just works really well in my brows, which is why I picked this palette over other palettes to kind of make it dual purpose. But I still obviously can use the blush palette that I used for my cheeks, and I'm just taking a little bit of the blush that we use because it is a little bit more warm toned, and I'm just applying it through my eye socket just to warm it up a little bit. It's all powder, so you can obviously use it anywhere all over your face and use it for different things. I'm taking an eyeshadow brush and I'm just mixing these two shimmery shades in with each other because I feel like this shade's a little bit too dark for what I'm looking for, and then this is a lot too light for what I prefer. And I'm not going to apply this too heavily. I just sort of want a wash of shimmer right on my eyelid, just a little bit of shimmer. I think that looks really pretty and soft, kind of effortless. For my mascara, I'm going to be using the e.l.f. Keep Your Curl mascara. The few times I've used this mascara in videos, I haven't really loved it that much, but I actually think for natural looks like these, the mascara does look really cute. I find this mascara gives a pretty decent amount of volume but good separation, which is really nice in a mascara. I find that mascaras that do give a lot of volume, they kind of lack the ability to make your lashes look really nice and separated. But I think this mascara does a good job at that. I do know at the drugstore though, you can find even cheaper mascaras. Like I think Wet n Wild has a really nice mascara and it's only like $3 or something, but this is what I had in my collection and I didn't want to go spend money on something that I didn't really need. So yeah, just using this one. To finish off the look, e.l.f. has a lot of really affordable lip options. So I could either do the e.l.f. lip lacquer, and I have the shade Moody, and this lip gloss does look very cute. Or I could do the e.l.f. Seriously Satin Lipstick in the shade Nectar. And this color is really nice and flattering. It's a cute peachy color that I actually think would look really good with my cheeks. So I'm going to go ahead and apply this shade today. So yeah, that is the completed look. 5 products, $20, and you get a look like this. That's pretty amazing. I think that this looks awesome. I think that this is a great everyday look. I think everyone can achieve a look like this. I am really excited to see what you guys think of the look that I was able to create with only 5 products and for $20. I think that this looks fantastic. I 100% would wear this on a daily basis, honestly. And I could even see people being surprised when they hear that this only cost me $20 and only used 5 products. There is no area on my face that I feel looks incomplete. I even think the lipstick makes the look a little bit more sophisticated and done. I love love the eyes. I love the eyebrows. I honestly would consider replacing my brow products with this eyeshadow palette and just use that eyeshadow for my brows like every day. I think the lip color is so cute and I think that these are fantastic. I cannot wait to continue using these blush duos, especially in future drugstore videos, because I think that they perform really nicely. If you guys want to see another $20 makeup challenge, obviously not using a full face of e.l.f. Cosmetics, let me know in the comments down below, because I do feel some of you guys will think that this video was cheating a little bit, but I still love the look that I was able to do using all e.l.f. Cosmetics, only 5 products for $20. I cannot get over that this face is 5 products for $20. I think it's crazy. But that is going to be it for me today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope that you enjoyed today's video. If you aren't already subscribed, definitely go ahead and do so, and hopefully I see you next time.